Hi, I just wanted to make a few observations about the ZX7200 IGBT inverter welder, which I purchased off eBay for a total shipping and the device itself of $133. This is a 230 volt welder, 230 volt AC input welder that comes with a cable that there are only two wires in. One is red, one is green. And I'll let you sort that out. I had to buy the $15 plus tax connector for the AC line. I think they rated it 32 amps. My breaker's a 30 amp breaker and it hasn't kicked. They also include just the connectors for your cables. I think that's some sort of standard welding connector. They include the boot, and I had some heat shrink to provide a little additional strain relief, which has glue in it. Seems pretty nice. I also had to obviously buy a ground clamp and a stinger, which I think you can buy the stingers for $15. I think I have a total of about $200 in it. I don't know what's available as a complete kit for $200. You might be able to see it has one knob. It says 10 to 200 amps. I haven't had it at 200 amps. Probably 130, 140 would be the highest I've had it on anything. I know it burns 1/8 inch 70/18s just fine. They rated, I think, at 65% duty cycle, which I thought was totally crazy. But the doggone thing just works. And about 86% efficiency. It is a forced air, meaning there's a fan back here, intake through these vents. And I use it probably in 50 to 75 degree ambient temperature for not a lot of welding. So it doesn't really appear to get hot. I just leave it on a little after my last attempt at a weld and shut it off. The power switch is in the back. It's very light. You can lift it up with just a couple of fingers, like 9 pounds. Then there are some mechanical issues with this thing I'd like to show you. As far as the electrical part, it's done great. It has done fine. The circuit boards look to be standard type electronic construction that I would not complain about, but there are a couple of things internally I'd like for you to see if you're thinking about buying one of these, because it probably is going to be best not to handle it roughly. Here is where I have real questions about this box, and you just remember what you're paying for. It's not a whole lot. There's a standoff that was part of this molded assembly that is the back cover for this little welder. When it came out of the box had no shipping damage. This standoff was broke, and the screw went through the plastic standoff and into the rail. So there was nothing holding it at that corner. At the same time, on the front, you can see where the same thing has happened. I don't know how to fix that. I'm not going to try to glue it, but it goes together. So that's good enough. I'd just be really careful where I took this thing, how I slung it around. I plan on leaving it on the table downstairs and not moving it unless I have to, like I did now, just to take it apart. It's kind of an amazing little box that you can get 200 amps out of an inverter for a welder. You know, I came through the days where you had diodes and transformers and just huge, huge, heavy devices.